Good morning. For those of you who are visiting, welcome to Transfiguration. Our presider today is our parochial vicar, Father Bill, and he's being assisted by Deacon Peter Harris. Please rise.
Enter into the presence of the Lord as we begin in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Grace and peace and love of God our Father and of our Lord Jesus Christ be with all of you.
And with your spirit.
As we come together to celebrate this day, the Lord invites us into his mercy and his love.
Lord Jesus, you raise us to new life. Kyrie eleison. Lord Jesus, you forgive us our sins. Christe eleison. Jesus, you feed us with your body and blood. Kyrie eleison.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
We give you thanks for your
Let us pray. O God, who teach us that your abiding in our hearts that is just and true, grant that we may be fashioned by your grace to be the dwelling pleasing to you, the Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the book of Leviticus. The Lord said to Moses and Aaron, if someone on you has a scab or a pustule or a blotch, which appears to be a sore of leprosy, he shall be brought to Aaron the priest or to one of the priests among his descendants. If the man is leprous and unclean, the priest shall declare him unclean by reason of the sore on his head. The one who bears the sore of leprosy shall keep his garments rent and his head bare and shall muffle his beard. He shall cry out, unclean, unclean. As long as the sore is on him, he shall declare himself unclean, since he is in fact unclean. He shall dwell apart, making his abode outside the camp. The word of the Lord.
I turn to you in time of trouble, and you fill me with the joy of salvation. I turn to you in time of trouble, and you fill me with the joy of salvation. Happy is he whose sin is forgiven, whose fault is taken away. Happy is she whom God shall find of an innocent heart, in whose soul there is no crime. I turn to you in time of trouble, and you fill me with the joy of salvation. I kept my sin held deep in my soul, and my frame was wasted away. Night and day was your hand a weight upon my heart. I was weak, racked with fever and alone. I turn to you in time of trouble, and you fill me with the joy of salvation. Then I acknowledge the pain of my sin, and my guilt I overcome. I said I confessed my soul unto you, and you took away the guilt of my sin. I turn to you in time of trouble, and you fill me with the joy of salvation.
From the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, whether you eat or drink or whatever you do, do everything for the glory of God. avoid giving offense, whether to the Jews or Greeks or to the Church of God. Just as I try to please everyone in every way, not seeking my own benefit, but that of the many, that they may be saved. Be imitators of me, as I am of Christ. The word of the Lord.
Be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark. A leper came to Jesus and kneeling down begged him and said, "If you wish, you can make me clean." Moved with pity, he stretched out his hand, touched him, and said to him, "I do will it. Be made clean." The leprosy left him immediately, and he was made clean. Then warning him sternly, he dismissed him at once. He said to him, "See that you tell no one anything, but go, show yourself to the priest and offer for your cleansing what Moses prescribed. That will be proof for them." The man went away and began to publicize the whole matter. He spread the report abroad, so that it was impossible for Jesus to enter a town openly. He remained outside in deserted places, and people kept coming to him from everywhere. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. At this time, we will hear a message from our Archbishop about the upcoming Archbishop's annual appeal. Next Sunday, Father Fernando will explain further how we can participate in this important opportunity to help others.
My dear friends, over the past year, as I have reacquainted myself with the Archdiocese of Atlanta, it has been a sort of homecoming for me. I served here for 16 years as pastor and have many wonderful memories. Because I was installed as your archbishop during this coronavirus pandemic, this is the first opportunity I have had to address the entire archdiocese. And so I want to say to you the most important thing first. Even though my travel and interactions with people have been limited these past months of social distancing, I have felt tremendous love and support from you. In these difficult times, your faith has strengthened my faith. And so I say very simply, not just as head of the Archdiocese, but as a spiritual father, I love you. I care about you and your well-being and your spiritual health. I thank God for you and I pray for you every day. Today's scripture speaks of healing. Like the leper, we certainly long for a physical cure for this virus. Many of us long for healing in different areas of our lives. Thankfully, as we see in today's gospel, every time Jesus heals a physical ailment, it always has a spiritual dimension. For the leper, healing was not just a relief from a physical disease. Just as importantly, it meant that he could become part of the community again. We have a similar challenge in our parishes today, don't we? Despite cautions and restrictions, we long to operate like true communities again. And so, for this year's annual appeal, I've chosen the theme, Our Joyful Return to the Lord. This theme has a triple meaning. First, it is a call to conversion, a challenge to return to the Lord with your whole hearts. Secondly, it is a call to action, to give generously of yourself to the church. And thirdly, it is an invitation to return to regular attendance at Mass, especially those who are healthy. Practically speaking, how can we return to the Lord? I would propose the tried and true paths the saints have shown us: prayer, sacraments, and service. First, we must recognize those of us who are faithful. We are the heart and the hands of the church. Our devotion and example keeps our parishes alive. From the bottom of my heart, thank you for your faithfulness. Please continue to be salt of the earth and light to the world. All of us, though, are called to continual conversion. True happiness in life can only be found in relationship with Jesus. Daily prayer is essential to develop this relationship, and so is forgiveness. As soon as we can, we need to return to the sacrament of reconciliation. It may be from behind a mask or from a car window, but like the leper, actively seek God's healing. Some of you are listening to this message from your pews, but many of you are watching online. I want to invite all Catholics of good health to come back to Mass, not just via phone or a computer, but at your home parish. The Eucharist is a physical reality. Our Sunday gathering is a time to be happy in the Lord, to be fed, refreshed, and renewed. If you are of good health, please come back home to Mass. Finally, to truly demonstrate your faith, get involved in service. None of us have a me and God relationship. We must be involved in a Christian community. We must be working with others to serve the poor, to educate our children in the faith, study the scriptures, and in 100 other ways. There is not a deeper truth than the one St. Francis of Assisi gave us. In losing yourself, you will find yourself. In giving, you will receive. And St. Paul reminds us that we must decrease and he must increase. Prayer, sacraments, and service are all a sure path to the Lord, a path that I am on as well. My duty is to make the Archdiocese a place where every person can encounter Jesus in a meaningful way. This task is not easy, and so I ask for your help. First, please pray for me as I begin my ministry here, making difficult decisions and guiding the Archdiocese the best way that I know how. Secondly, warmly support your priests, deacons, and seminarians. They are my brothers in ministry, and they need your love and care. Thirdly, become personally involved in your parish. The church is not just the archbishop, and not just the priests, not just an institution. The church is the body of Christ and is alive through you. Even with all the safety protocols needed right now, we must find creative ways to serve each other. Fourthly, generously support your parish and your archdiocese. I love the word for stewardship that our Latino brothers and sisters use. Corresponsabilidad, co-responsibility. We must pull ourselves together to meet our obligations, which are many. We have tremendous expenses to train our future priests, to serve the poor and the addicted, feed the hungry, and to educate our children in the faith. Despite these needs, during my first annual appeal, I want to be crystal clear. Your financial support is not the bottom line. The true bottom line is that you have given your heart to Jesus and that you seek him through prayer, sacraments, and service. Yes, the Archdiocese needs your financial support, but the true wealth of the church are the souls of each Catholic. Please be generous with your money, but more than that, be generous with yourself. Give yourself to God. I close with the words of Pope Francis in his letter, The Joy of the Gospel. I invite all Christians everywhere at this very moment to a renewed personal encounter with Jesus Christ. No one should think that this invitation is not meant for him or her. Whenever we take a step toward Jesus, we come to realize that he is already there, waiting for us with opened arms. And may the Lord grant you his peace. Amen.
Because of the Archbishop's annual appeal message, I've been asked to be very brief today. And I think today about the reality of what our nation celebrates, a day that they call Valentine's Day, a day where cupids shoot arrows and people fall in love. Watch out for the arrows. But the reality of this day is a day of a blessed person, not very well renowned in the church because of his simplicity of life. Valentine gave his life to the church, serving God and his people with his heart, with his soul,
with all that he had and all that he was. His grave is a very mysterious place because it's outside the Basilica Mary Major, the cathedral of the Pope. And as we celebrate this day, and as we wish people happy Valentine's, maybe what we should be doing is wishing people a blessed Valentine's, the blessing of St. Valentine upon us, as I believe that in heaven he is praying for us, helping us to be a people who are aligned with the love of God and his church. Keep aligning ourselves to that heart of Christ, the heart that Valentine had for desiring to be a priest in a troubled time, serving his people with all that he had and all that he was and all that he could give. I think that's what today is about for us. The reality of God's love for us, giving us a saint who may not be a major saint in the church, but is profoundly humble, simple, and little like us. Someone who may never be recognized when we go to our resting place in God's presence, but in God's eyes, we are powerfully wonderful and loving in his sight. Blessed Valentine's Day to you all. Our profession is what we believe and who we are. And so today we cry out to the Lord with our prayer. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. And by the Holy Spirit, was implored of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Today we turn to the Lord with our hearts, all that we are and all that we have, asking the Lord to continue to strengthen us as his faithful people. Our response is, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer. For the church, may we be compassionate to those who are unwanted or unwelcomed in our society. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our parish, that we may respond generously to our Archbishop's annual appeal as faithful stewards of the gifts entrusted to us. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For peace in the world, may God's angels watch over those who protect others from harm. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our country, may our leaders engage in honest dialogue and compromise as they chart our path forward. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who are living in the sacrament of marriage, bless them in good times and in bad, in sickness and in health, and help them to be true to one another all the days of their life. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who are sick, may God quiet their fears and heal them in body and spirit. we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the repose of the soul of Lorraine Brown, for whom this Mass is offered, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have died, especially Kathy Egan and Louis Sykes, may our loved ones be embraced by the saints and surrounded in glory. May those who mourn be comforted. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for your own intentions, held in silence.
Father, we turn to you this day as you have created us out of love. So as we celebrate this day of St. Valentine, we may recognize the love of your church, the love of us, your people. We may always dwell in working to create the harmony that you have for us through Christ our Lord. My sisters and brothers, that this, my sacrifice and yours, may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept your sacrifice for your hands.
May this oblation, O Lord, we pray, cleanse and renew us, and may it become for those who do your will a source of eternal reward. Through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, mighty and eternal God, through Jesus Christ our Lord. For through the Paschal mystery, he accomplished the marvelous deeds by which he has freed us from the yoke of sin and death and summoned us to the glory of being now chosen race, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, a people of your own possession, to proclaim everywhere your mighty works, for you have called us out of darkness into your own wonderful light. So with the angels, the archangels, the thrones and dominions, the hosts and the powers of heaven, we sing a hymn of your glories without end, we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts,
indeed holy, O Lord, the fountain of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed, he entered willingly into his passion. He took bread, gave you thanks. He broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you. Similar way, when the supper was ended, he took the chalice once more, gave thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sin. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly, we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ be gathered in one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world. Bring her to the fullness of charity. Together with Francis, our Holy Father, with Gregory John, the Archbishop, with Joel and Bernard, his brother bishops, and all your clergy. Remember all our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in hope of the resurrection, who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into life your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin, Mary, Mother of God, with our blessed spouse, Saint Joseph, with the blessed apostles, and with all the saints, especially Saint Valentine, who pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs of eternal life. We praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, O glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Father joins us as one with him, and so we pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our day. By the help of your mercy, make us always free from sin, safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ said to your apostles, peace I leave with you, my peace I give to you. Look not on our sin, but on the faith of your church. Graciously grant us peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with all of you.
And with your spirit. Let us offer each other a sign of peace.
Bread of life.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who has come to take away the sins of the world. Blessed are we who are called to this supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. If you're joining us for Mass online, please pray this prayer now. My Jesus, on the day of my baptism, you poured your love into my heart through the Holy Spirit, who unites me eternally to you. Through that same Spirit, I pledge my love and adore you, present in your most holy body and blood. Though I cannot consume you in this sacred banquet, let me be consumed by your complete desire for me, so that my longing for you may be filled by your love alone, and your mercy overflow through me into this world so in need. Amen. With all the earth we sing your praise. We come to give you thanks, O lover of us all, and giver of our loving. With sun and moon we dance for joy. We are your work of art, the glory of your hand, the children of your loving. As I know of your labor, so I watch while you sleep, ever close at your calling, so my love will be. With all the earth we sing your praise. We come to give you thanks, O lover of us all, and giver of our loving. With sun and moon we dance for joy. We are your work of art, the glory of your hand, the children of your loving. If the night would surround you and the sun fall from sight, yet my hand will protect you. I will be your light. With all the earth we sing your praise. We come to give you thanks, O lover of us all, and giver of our loving. With sun and moon we dance for joy. We are your work of art, the glory of your hand, the children of your loving.
Mine, but now I see.
Let us pray. Having fed upon these heavenly delights, we pray, O Lord, that we may always long for the food by which we truly live through Christ our Lord. Amen. And so anyone who is wishing to renew their vows, please remain standing. I hope the husbands didn't sit down. Or the wives. I ask you to please repeat after me to one another these vows. I recommit myself to this holy relationship of marriage, to have and to hold, for better or for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish all the days of my life. May the Lord keep you safe all your days of your life. May he comfort you in adversity and support you in prosperity. May he fill your homes with blessings through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, Father, Son, Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. Let us go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.